Did you know you can drown in Fortnite? You can also get prosecuted if you're caught hacking. So here are 40 things you probably didn't know about Fortnite. It's crazy, but Fortnite was meant to be a zombie game at first. They originally wanted the game similar to Save the World, gameplay-wise, but they wanted players to have a really terrifying and over-the-top experience while playing at first, until they scrapped that idea. Then although they scrapped that, they still scared players with the jump scare prank, because in the Fortnite Mares 2019 update, they decided to add a little joke near the end. They made it so that soccer skin zombies would spawn out of nowhere and start attacking players. I don't know if something like that would be banned in Fortnite China, since they have pretty strict rules, because any skin or item with a skull is banned in the Chinese version of Fortnite, since it's considered very culturally insensitive in China to depict things like skulls in video games. Then you're also only allowed to play Fortnite for up to 3 hours in China as well. But this only applies to minors. If you're over 18 or your account has been verified by an adult, you don't have to worry about that rule. But it is a good thing that Fortnite China still receives new updates, because the mobile version of Fortnite is still stuck in Chapter 2, Season 3. And the reason for this is because of the Epic vs. Apple lawsuit. When Apple removed Fortnite from the App Store, this prevented Fortnite from releasing any new updates to mobile players, since they'd have to do it through the App Store. Due to this, Fortnite lost over 166 million players when the Apple vs. Epic lawsuit started. That's 60% of its iOS players after the Apple ban, which is mainly because these players, well, they can't receive anything new. No updates, same old stuff. But before Fortnite was removed from the App Store, they made a ton of money from it. They actually made $15 million within the first 3 weeks of it being on the App Store. This means Fortnite made more money than Candy Crush, Clash of Clans, and Pokemon Go on a weekly basis, within just 3 weeks. But not all players really had the chance to play Fortnite Mobile due to them getting banned. Earlier on in the game, there used to be a swing set glitch. If you jumped on one, it would bug out and trick the server into thinking you were speed hacking. And Epic started to ban players who did this, but the players were later unbanned due to it being Epic's fault. Very much contrasting to that, people who use aimbot could potentially get sued. In 2017, Fortnite actually sued a 14-year-old player who made a video of himself using and selling cheats. To be fair, he was in major violation of Epic's copyright by using cheats to modify the game's code. Epic has had many legal troubles over the years, because PUBG devs tried suing when Fortnite started blowing up. After all, they claimed that Fortnite copied aspects of their game, including the user interface and weapons designs, but they later dropped that lawsuit. And although Fortnite did take inspiration from PUBG, they also did so with Apex Legends, because Apex had vaults, the ping system, and reboot vans before Fortnite. But after Fortnite noticed those, they decided to introduce them into their own game. And frankly, I'm glad they did, because could you imagine Fortnite without reboot vans now? Then it also may appear that they took gold and bounties from Call of Duty Warzone, because Warzone had the bounty contract system before Fortnite as well as gold. But it is cool that they added this, because who doesn't love completing a bounty? And I think it would be good to give them to all NPCs, like how it was in Chapter 2, Season 5. But not everything is directly inspired by other people's intellectual properties, because the Infinity Blade released during Season 7 is actually from another game made by Epic named Infinity Blade. And this is a medieval mobile game where players could fight one-on-one battles against each other, but Fortnite later vaulted the Infinity Blade because of how overpowered it was. Now, the Auto Shotty probably would have been just as overpowered as the Infinity Blade, and the Auto Shotty is a shotgun that was supposed to come out, but this version of the shotgun got cancelled. Look at this. The same thing happened with the Beehive Grenade that was also supposed to come out, but got scrapped. These would have spawned a swarm of bees for 12 seconds when thrown, which would have dealt damage every second. They probably would have been just as annoying as fireflies. And I just don't understand why Fortnite scrapped so many updates, because they did the same with the It Collab. In Season X, Fortnite attached red balloons to storm drains to pay homage to It. And we were supposed to get an It collaboration after that, but It never happened. And right after Season X was the black hole. If you don't know, this was another prank or publicity stunt that Fortnite pulled to build hype for Chapter 2. They even deleted all of their tweets from their Twitter page to make it really seem like it was the end. They kept this going for 2 days. After the 2 days were up, they released Chapter 2, and this had all types of new features such as fishing, boats, and swimming. But did you know that you can drown in Fortnite? It can happen if you get trapped underwater, or if you get trapped by builds while you're in water. Drowning is pretty annoying, so I feel like it could be good if they were to patch that, but it's good that they didn't patch rocket riding. This was a glitch that Fortnite decided to just leave in the game because of how cool they thought it was, and how cool the players thought it was. It is nice that they let stuff found by players stay in the game, but they also add stuff made by players. Haunted Hills was actually made by a fan of Fortnite called Blorfy, but they made a few changes when they introduced it to the game. Still overall, really cool. And it's evidently not common for fan-made POIs to get added, but it is with skins because the Tender Defender was a concept made by a fan of Fortnite. The idea of the skin was created by an 8-year-old boy named Connor. The idea was loved by the Fortnite community on Reddit, so Fortnite later added it into the game. The Tender Defender is a skin that many players would like to merge on their accounts with how good it looks. Fortnite removed the account merging feature right before Season 9, due to there being too many bugs associated with account merging. On top of that, there were a lot of scammers trying to steal accounts around that time. I will say it is good that they did that to prevent scams, but they can't stop all scams and cheats. Two players were able to allegedly cheat their way into the World Cup. If you didn't know, Fortnite allowed Ziff and Ronaldo into the World Cup, and it would seem that they cheated to get in. Due to this, they received a lot of hate and crowd boos when they were mentioned at the World Cup. Neither Ziff nor Ronaldo were banned from the World Cup, but a school in England actually banned use of the floss dance from Fortnite. The school said that they banned it because the dance moves were used to intimidate children, and they claimed that Fortnite was affecting their students' learning behaviors. Back to in-game stuff, if they kept friendly fire, that definitely would have affected Fortnite players as well. In the earlier seasons of the game, there used to be friendly fire, but they had to remove it because you'd have teammates eliminating each other and being toxic afterwards. It was bad. And back when friendly fire used to be in Fortnite, the purple tack was also in the game. And this tack had similar stats to the newer purple tack, but at the time, this used to be the best shotgun in the game, before players discovered the double pump meta. And all of that got removed over time, but not as fast as the Eye of the Storm tracker got removed. This was the quickest vaulted Fortnite item of all time. It was a book bag that would show you where the next circle would have been located. And this book bag disappeared under 30 minutes after its addition. People aren't sure if they vaulted it that quickly due to glitches or something, maybe it was just an accidental add. Speaking of glitches though, the Star Wand used to have a glitch where it did 56 damage. Fortnite quickly took action when they found out about this because a pickaxe that could eliminate you in 2-4 hits was extremely broken. Just like turbo farming, because there used to be a pickaxe glitch back in the old days where you could do an emote to farm materials 2 times faster than usual. This was very good when it was possible, especially since it took forever to get max materials back then. It really is crazy how Fortnite has had so many glitches, but did you know, this game originally was inspired by a Japanese film named Battle Royale. The film was released in 2000, and now we have Fortnite Battle Royale, released in 2017. But the actual initial announcement of Fortnite was at the 2011 Spike Video Game Awards, but they wouldn't release anything until 2014, because at the time, Fortnite was just an idea that still needed a lot of work. But of course, the game wouldn't fully be released to the public until 2017. And that means it's officially been 1,474 days since Fortnite was released, and the Hachivat skin hasn't appeared in the item shop in nearly 1,000 of those days. The last time it was released was in December of 2018, which makes it the rarest item shop skin in the game. And it seems that Travis Scott might be one of the rarest Icon Series skins, but did you know that the Travis Scott live event had over 12.3 million live viewers while it took place? And the video of it has received over 164 million views on YouTube so far. Fortnite collabs very commonly get a lot of hype. And I know a Family Guy collab would have had a ton of hype as well. It was leaked that we were supposed to be getting this collaboration since Family Guy files were found in Fortnite, but we can still hope we'll receive it at some point, and at least it didn't get completely cancelled like Friday Fortnite. This was a competitive tournament hosted by Keemstar, where teams of two would kill race and see who would get the most eliminations in a best 2-of-3 series, and the winning team would be awarded $10,000. But after a bit of time, Fortnite put a stop to that. This did make many fans quite upset, but what made them happy was when Fortnite added preferred item slots. This was basically an idea that a Fortnite fan presented on Reddit about 3 years ago that's just now getting added into the game. But they don't only add items made by fans to the game, they also add stuff that they're fans of. For example, they've got the Primo Moves emote from the dance Claire does in The Breakfast Club. We've also got the codename Elf based on Buddy from the movie Elf, the golf clap from a scene in Men at Work, and they also took cars from GTA. Just joking, but you probably didn't know that you can actually reboot while in a vehicle, that's something. Now click the video on your screen. Click it right now!